So next topic is sulfur nitrogen compounds. So this is very simple concept. So from here the questions will be asked, many questions asked from this topic. So here we have three sulfur nitrogen compound, S4N4, then S2N2, then SNX. This is very easy to remember. So S2N2, we can prepare from S4N4, and SNX will prepare from S2N2. So initially we have SCl2, 6 moles of SCl2, and we'll treat this one with 16 moles of ammonia. We'll get N2S4 plus 1/4 S8 plus 12 NH4Cl. So this N2S4 is not stable. So this decomposes into N2S2. Okay. So this is a this is, if you allow for some time, it decomposes into N2S2. And one more procedure also there. If we pass this compound through the silver wool, then also it gets converted into N2S2. So these are the methods to prepare N2S2 from the N2S4. Then what about the SNX? So N2S2 is less stable than N4S4. So this is more stable than this, but still this is a not that stable as we compared with N2S2. N2S4 is more stable. So since it's a less stable, so this gets converted into SNX. Okay, so N2S2, if we keep it for some time at 0 degree centigrade, so it gets converted into SNX polymer. So this polymer appears as a bronze colored zigzag polymer. Okay, and now we'll go for the structure of S4N4, and here the main important thing is SNX. Why it's very important means, so this can conduct the this compound is stable up to 240 degree centigrade. I'm not sure about the temperature. I think it is stable up to 240 degrees temperature, and this conducts the metallic conductivity. And it also becomes superconductivity at 0.3 Kelvin. Superconductivity below 0.3 Kelvin. So here what we need to remember, that SNX compound polymer can be prepared by allowing N2S2, keeping N2S2 for some time at 0 degree temperature. We'll get a SNX polymer, and it's a bronze colored zigzag polymer, and this is stable up to 240 degree temperature, and this can conduct the metallic conductivity, and if we keep at 0.3 Kelvin, it acts as a superconductor. Okay, and the properties are there. We'll talk about the properties later, and first we'll talk about the S4N4 structure. So here all four nitrogens are in the plane. Okay, like this, in the plane, and each nitrogen is connected by the one sulfur, two sulfurs are above, two sulfurs are below, and you remove these bonds. So this is the structure of S4N4, and this S4N4 undergoes reaction with Lewis acids. Okay, so now if we take one equivalent of BF3, so where it can react, on nitrogen or sulfur? So just we need to see which one is a more basic. So nitrogen is more basic, so that's why the Lewis acid goes and attacks to the only one nitrogen like this. Like this. So now we'll go for the SNX compound chemical reactions. So this SNX can react with ICl, IBr and I2, and now the whatever the product comes here, this product is 16 times higher conductor. Conductor than SNX. It's very, very important. So SNX is a polymer which is forming by the reacting of from the S2N2. Now this SNX can conduct the metallic conductivity, and if we allow to stand at 0.3 Kelvin, below 0.3 Kelvin, then it can conduct a superconductivity. So, and this can react with ICl, IBr and I2, and it produces one product, I mean a halogenated product. The halogenated SNX is 16 times higher conductor than the SNX. This is very, very important. So this is about the sulfur nitrogen compound. So it's very important and easy topic, and you just need to remember only three compound: S4N4, S2N2 and SNX.